My man right here is too smooth, though. Too smooth. Why y'all hating, though?
Follow me on Instagram at @ball_out_cam.
Good. And it's going to be right here. And it's going to be right here.
Follow me on Instagram @_Amari.
And it's going to be right here.
And then follow me, Supreme_J56. YouTube Supreme Jeezy.
And it, you, what? Really? You want to take my screen name like that?
I'm going to change it. Don't worry.
I did too.
Before that, before he had 8 subscribers on YouTube, I knew.
This guy right here is like family to me, Ricky Nutt. He's an 8th grade teacher at Franklin Middle School, also a pastor at Revival Center in Vallejo, which I attend. He's definitely someone I look up to. He wanted me to come down to show love to his class, so that's what I did. Came down to show love to support these guys and what these guys are doing.
I knew we had -1, but I'm just kidding.
Me?
I need a haircut.
What? This intro gonna be so long, you guys. We gotta say, we gotta say, it's 360 Jeezy. I mean, y'all don't have to make y'all vocals go there, but is there anyone in here that don't know the song?
I know this part. I know the part that we need.
You know the part that we need?
Yep.
All right, he knows the part that we need. 1, 2, 3.
It's 360 Jeezy.
Y'all were so dry. Y'all was so dry. We gotta do it all over again. All right, 1, 2, 3. It's 360 Jeezy. YouTube, in this video, I did a low fade with a part with some long hair on the top. Hold on, where my man at with the long hair?
Right here.
I mean, it was him, but it was another guy in a different period. But
Jewel.
I was gonna describe to y'all what it was, but see what had happened was he left.
He wanted his haircut.
He So in this video, I did long hair, okay, low fade with a part on the side. Stay tuned. Start this video off by putting my clips in to separate the long hair at the top from the bottom. Right now I'm combing down the hair, making sure everything is laid with the grain. Now using the Andis Masters with the 3-guard open, I'm going against the grain, making sure everything is even. I've got my comb in place, separating the top from the bottom, and making sure that I don't go into the long hair at the top. Amount of bulk, you want to make sure that you brush the hair back down in place. You don't want to be putting in your guidelines and setting a sloppy blend when everything is not brushed down with the grain. So when you do with the grain, it makes for a cleaner blend. Now using my Andis Slimline Pro Li's, I'm setting in my bulk guideline, and then this is basically a low fade, so I'm going up and around his ear, dropping it back down, and then going up and around his ear very low. Now with the magic clips, I'm balding out. I'm taking off the rest of the hair because I don't want to dull out my liners. Shavers, it's time to put in that razor bald line at the bottom. Now, here's a tip for you guys. When you're using these shavers, you don't want to go all the way up to that bald line that you set in. You want to leave some room as if these shavers are a guideline in itself. Basically, you're going to go up, but just don't go all the way up to that line because it'll set in a real harsh guideline if you do that. Using my Oster's fast feeds with the lever open, I'm setting in that next guideline. Now notice how I'm not going too close to my client's lineup because I want to leave that area dark. So I'm setting in a smaller guideline by his lineup area, and I'm going an inch as I go back. With the one guard open, I'm going a full inch, and notice how it doesn't really matter how close I get to my client's lineup because it's gonna be at a one anyway. So, you know, I'm just setting in that guideline and making sure everything is neat and even. With the two guard open, doing the same thing, go up another inch, and basically knock off that bulk from the top. Most of the time when you set in those guidelines from the one from the two, there's gonna be a line. So what I'm doing is having the one guard open and just flicking out to that line to where it disappears. With the one guard closed, it's time to flick out that middle line. Keep in mind that this is not gonna take out the middle line. This is gonna soften it up so you could come behind it and get it out with the next guideline. Now with the zero closed, flick out that middle line. Now I see some bulk at the top, so I'm gonna lighten it up with the two guard open. Now with the lever closed, flick out that bottom line. Thank you. you guys will notice that the line at the bottom isn't completely taken out. So I'm using my Andis shavers and I'm just going downward to knock out that harsh line at the bottom. After you set in those guidelines, it's necessary to do detail work, okay? Take a step back, look at your blend, see what you can work on, and you know, attack areas that you that are a little bit bulky and a little bit spotty. So basically that's what I'm doing. I'm using my corners to get in areas where, you know, it just seems a little, you know, bulky. Right now I'm doing the part, and I'm only teach you guys how to do a part, and to let you guys know it's not that deep, okay? Notice how my part right now isn't really like straight, like it isn't really, you know, on point. I'm just giving a rough draft right now and kind of, you know, putting it in, and then I'll come behind it and perfect the part, you know what I mean? So keep in mind there's always two edges to a part. There's a top edge and then there's a bottom half, and you guys will see me perfect it as I go on. You guys see I was working on the top half of the part, and now I'm working on the bottom half of the part. After you guys are done with your part, you want to razor line the part, because this makes everything pop. Everything is real crispy when you put a razor to your designs. Using my one guard open, going with the grain on this front lineup, I'm knocking it off so that I can give a crisp lineup. Tip, if you guys see a lot of bulk on the edge of your client's lineup, all you gotta do is brush the hair over in the opposite direction and, you know, take it off with your liners, and brush everything back in place and it'll be crispy. Cut, and if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. To everybody that comes out to see my videos early, to my notification gang, what's good? I see y'all, I love y'all, I love the support that I'm getting from all my supporters. But it's your boy 360 Jeezy, and I'm out of here. Cheers.